10 seconds remaining. MVPs turn to ban. Ten seconds remaining. Team Secrets turn to ban. Ten seconds remaining. 5 seconds remaining. MVPs turn to ban. Team Secrets turn to pick. Ten seconds remaining. 5 seconds remaining. MVPs turn to pick. 10 seconds remaining. 5 seconds remaining. Reserve time.
Life Stealer.
Elder Titan.
Team Secrets turn to pick. Ten seconds remaining. 5 seconds remaining.
Sand King.
MVPs turn to ban. Ten seconds remaining. 5 seconds remaining. Team Secrets turn to ban. Ten seconds remaining. 5 seconds remaining. MVPs turn to ban. Ten seconds remaining. 5 seconds remaining. Reserve time.
I should have seen that one coming.
Team Secrets turn to ban. Ten seconds remaining. 5 seconds remaining. MVP's turn to pick.
Dark Seer.
Team Secret's turn to pick. Ten seconds remaining. 5 seconds remaining. Reserve time.
And welcome back, everybody. It's game number two of MVP Phoenix versus Team Secret. I hope you guys enjoyed watching the end of Newbie versus VGR while we waited for game number two to be underway. We certainly enjoyed it. Seemed like one hell of a clash towards the end of this, but we have to get into the draft of MVP Phoenix and Team Secret as we are already halfway through a Lifestealer, Elder Titan, and a Darkseer for MVP Phoenix, while Team Secret will opt for the Wisp and Sand King. This time around, Blitz, MVP Phoenix will grab that Lifestealer despite not having Yuriki or Bounty Hunter available to them.
Fairly surprising that they didn't ban the Wisp, and that they were more worried about the Ursa and the Huskar.
Mm-hmm.
So I think they just conceded, okay, they're going to take Wisp. What are we going to get in response? In response, they get the Life Sealer. They lose the vehicle for it, though, is the unfortunate part.
Right.
What I think makes MVP's Life Sealer so strong is they almost always attach a vehicle to it, and all four of those have been banned this game.
Yes, they certainly have. I'm not sure how many other heroes.
What else can they turn into their taxi?
Well, you don't really want to with this kind of lineup, but there's certain initiating mids like Puck. Don't think you would have a whole lot of a real good lineup. It would just be fighting, fighting, fighting. And if you don't succeed in fighting, 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 and winning heavily 25 minutes, then you're probably donezo.
Kind of curious about that Sand King. It seems like this hero has kind of just been moving up the ladder just little by little.
Mm-hmm.
I've seen some mixed success with it. We saw Na'Vi use it quite often, but not really sure the direction that they want to take with it. They still need one of those heroes to pump up. They've both taken Io and Dazzle. Now they absolutely need a hero that they can just send forth. You know, not have to really worry about.
Yeah.
Who are we guessing? You need a battler. This.
Mm-hmm.
Okay, here are my guesses. I think Terrorblade, Luna, remaining. And Dusa.
Have we seen a Luna yet?
I don't know. Maybe even a Dro. Who knows? I want to stick with those original three.
I would definitely be down with a Terrorblade against Lifestealer.
Hmm?
Sand King. Most likely our offlaner here. We've seen plenty of Sand King offlanes. We've seen a couple of them being picked up as mid, but it's most often because of the matchup more than anything else. The Sand King, as you said, has been ranking up. Do you think they want to match the Sand King against Darkseer? And does Sand King actually win that 1v1?
He does.
Yeah, he seems
so you think they
do okay, right?
They could potentially aggro so that they give the Sand King the 1v1 matchup?
Could be. Yeah, but I'm not sure if that, because I think Sand King does all right, and so you seem to back that up.
Damn.
I'm not sure if that's good enough, though.
Damn.
Why Annie?
Anti-Mage is good against Darkseer. It's good against Nagasiren.
Okay. And with the Darkseer.
But I'm still good with the other three heroes that I chose.
Terrorblade, Luna, and what?
I don't actually really like Luna that much.
Yeah.
TB and Alchemist. Oh.
MVP's turn to ban.
Is that the hero that they choose to just all in buff on?
I mean, do MVP Phoenix really have good heroes against Alchemist? Lifestealer's okay for a certain period of time, but eventually the armor starts to become too much for Lifestealer, and the other heroes are rather slow, I would say, in their damage. Nagasiren and Darkseer, so this would allow Alchemist's natural regen really come into play.
I'd agree with you there.
The obvious counter is Ancient Apparition, which will most likely be banned.
I think it'd be very silly not for Secret not to ban the AA, considering that I think we see it coming.
So we agree that the Alchemist, very strong pickup here against this lineup of MVP Phoenix.
All right, here's my out there pick.
Uh-huh.
You ban the AA, and you take the Necro. I'm not actually advocating for that, by the way. I'm still okay with my other ones. But if there's ever a time I'm going to see a Necromancer...
10 seconds remaining.
Here, our Necrolight. Our Necrophos.
Necrophos. Oh, come on, dude.
5 seconds
We're here remaining. At the International. You got to at least get the names right. Come on.
It's been a very long day.
I know. It has. There's the Ancient Apparition okay. ban so and Team Secrets. I'm not going to say Necrophos.
Yeah.
I think that's almost a little bit too far out there.
Okay, so they can't take Kedusa now. What, TB? 10 seconds remaining. Just run at you?
5 seconds remaining.
Kedusa, I'm sure there's a range.
TB.
I'm sure there's a range tower hitter that I'm not thinking of either. What's a bat?
Oh. Well, that's quite the switch up. This means Sand King will actually be a higher priority in farm than what we normally expect. So, is this is dual lanes, correct? So, Sand King, Dazzle... Wisp Alchemist, and then Batrider is our solo.
10 seconds remaining.
I mean, Wisp can kind of run around wherever he wants. He's a ball of light. Can't hold him down.
Sure. All right. I won't try and put my preconceived ideas of reserve time. Lanes and standards for our Wisp.
Caudle, maybe? I'm trying to think of a secondary support that goes with ET. Caudle, Phoenix, all of these.
I like Caudle with the Naga Siren. Play the movement game as best you can. MVP Phoenix can definitely go late game, right? Spirit Seeing
breaker.
As they're facing up against
Spirit
a sinking. Oh.
You know what you do? You retroactively go back in time and you take the Huskar yourself.
Well, seeing as that's not possible, MVP Phoenix will instead go for the much more feasible option of what is dual lanes? All melee heroes coming out of MVP. Kind of expect a range hero at the last pick, but Spirit Breaker Darkseer to match up against what is... Okay, Eternal Envy's actually taking the Batrider. I thought maybe Artur or Eternal Envy would actually be taking the Sand King, but...
You ready to call the 17th? I want everybody in chat to get super hype whenever it just spam it. Ruin everybody else's experience. Spam 17% when he hits bashes. We'll be right there with you. Get so hyped. You gotta get angry when you just gotta amp yourself up when you play this hero. Because you can't think about going back. There's no potential of losing a team fight when you have a Spirit Breaker.
You know, that really does fit MVP Phoenix's mentality. Yeah. There is no retreat for
Don't
them.
Get scared.
Run at them.
This hero does not have an escape mechanism. Pure, unfiltered offense. In the
All
form
right.
of a cow.
Team Secret versus MVP Phoenix, game number 2. Team Secret already 1 game up. MVP Phoenix going out for some all-out aggression. You said they didn't have a vehicle blitz for the Lifestealer. Well, they found one in their last pick, Spirit Breaker. Gonna be hitching a ride. And also, it makes for a pretty powerful dual lane if they want to pair that one up with the Darkseer, which I'm sure they are. Team Secret are currently making their way into the MVP Phoenix's side of the map with that smoke. Didn't really find anything. Didn't find a pickoff or anything like that. So they'll back away. Rather unsuccessful. They just get the aggressive ward inside the Dire Jungle, and that is all. All
right, prepare yourselves. Yubu, the most mild-mannered player here at TI. Prepared to just run at you. Have you seen that guy's profile picture on Steam?
No.
It's just him with a mustache. Him with a fake. It's been like that for 4 years. Sorry, I'm raising my voice.
All the way back when he was a Korean, just the Korean fanboy.
Yeah, and now look
and
at him.
Now look at him.
He gets to play Spearbreaker in the game of games.
Okay, that is a 3-man stun. Bebby is dead almost instantly off of the stun plus Shadow Wave. And I hope that MVP Phoenix are okay. Didn't give away first blood for any tactical reasons. Doesn't look so. That is... Wow, Team Secret. Bullying the enemy team despite having an Alchemist in the beginning of the game. Didn't seem to matter. Not with Bulba's Burrow Strikes.
That was pretty godly by Bulba, his positioning. That's a level 1 Burrow Strike. Look at the radius on that. It's horrible.
Yeah, still managed to hit three heroes. What is going on? All right, somebody's TPing out, right? Is Eternal Envy to the bottom lane?
Top, I think. Envy is all the way top already. Right.
All right, yeah. Eternal Envy goes down to the bottom lane.
Oh, that's what you're talking
about. Yeah. I was just like, I'll watch
it. I'm not used to seeing Eternal Envy Batrider.
No, certainly not.
First time I've seen it.
Bulba, slow down here. Still has his Burrow Strike. I know it too.
Jubu, here you go.
Charge.
All right, never mind.
He makes his appearance and they immediately say, not a kill, not a fight that we want to take. Not yet, anyway.
You can't overhype it yet, anyways. He doesn't have the mechanic.
Yeah, he needs that 17% first. Our mid lane is going to be QO, the Naga Siren, matched up against Arteezy and the free-flowing Pileidai Wisp. Don't want to lock him down to the mid lane, but he will spend at least a night or two here.
Yeah,
helping out our Alchemist.
Make life easier for yourself.
Yeah.
He's even going to... Oh, I love when supports do this, when they just kind of get it down under the tower so you can secure yourself the last hit.
Mm-hmm.
Does that for Arteezy once or twice. And Bulba top lane, looks like he's just going to get free farm against the 5 melee lineup.
Yeah. He's going to be having a pretty good time. So is the Batrider.
What are the rough number of regrets right now?
There's probably going to be a lot of them. Unless Dubu can go insane. He's now got his level 2. And he's going to start battling it out with Puppy and Bulba. Charges on through Bulba onto Puppy.
Oh!
Oh, that's the first.
Don't stop, Dubu!
Well, he's going to take a momentary pause.
All right, I'll accept that. Most of it just comes down to the fact that you've got to believe in it.
Mm-hmm.
All right, here we go, Dubu.
All right, here comes the charge. On a Pileidai, the stomp will land on Arteezy. Buff back by Dubu. They go straight for Pi. And that's going to be the first blood, unless no. Pileidai makes the tether out, and they go for the run down, but can't even get him. MVP Phoenix, they didn't believe hard enough in the 17% blitz.
Unfortunate, but this mid-courier walks up, just kind of gets bopped in the head.
Okay.
Secret, they realize what's going on, and... That could not have been First Blood, Cap. That was taken by Team Secret already.
That is true. I forgot about our three-man Burrow Strike to start.
Yes.
It didn't count, though. Come on, it was before the zero-minute mark.
Don't give the
Bulba. Those are fake First Bloods.
Don't try to take away Bulba's glory.
All right. Has been a long day. Dubu. Looking around between top and middle. Looking for any moment of weakness in Team Secret that he can pounce on. But doesn't really seem like there's much. Certainly not much at the bottom lane where Ferev is being chased away by Eternal Envy every Firefly he gets. Obviously, both of them are kind of trade and farm back and forth, and Ferev overall will be happy with the way this lane goes.
Yeah, and this ET, he's going to come down here, but it's still a Batrider that you're trying to gank.
Yeah.
I don't think Ferev is really in a position to really pressure too much.
There was a reason Dubu wasn't down here with the Darkseer, despite that being an amazing combination.
That's the combo.
Yeah. So why does Febby think he can replace Dubu like that?
Yeah, replace Dubu, man.
Yeah. So instead, he's going to head back to mid, realizing that his rotation was pretty futile.
When you're in a position where you haven't had to rotate once as Secret, you're incredibly comfortable. That just means you're all right with how the laning phase is going. You don't really have to accomplish too much just because you're getting a lot out of the laning phase already. Whereas it really looks like MVP feels so pressured to make something happen that they're almost just forcing things around the map right now. It almost feels like a repeat of last game.
Trying to hold on to the runes. Eternal Envy will snatch up that banner rune, knowing that there's no way that Team Secret be able to give it to Arteezy. MVP Phoenix have too much incentive to control these. Now they're going to head back up to top lane where MP is being gone on here. Pops the rage, starts battling it out with these two heroes. Reinforcements are on the way though in the form of Dubu. The cow incarnate comes in, bumps back both heroes and will be able to create the space for the Lifestealer to stay alive. But they won't really be able to stop Bulba, who's currently on a rampage in this top lane. Five melees. Uh-oh, Dubu in some trouble. Gets popped up. Dubu, he's going to take a little bit more damage as the poison comes out, but he will survive. This Sand King, though. Caustic Finale at its finest.
Man,
it's up against five melees.
I think Secret have kind of... They've just really done their homework. They have a really good understanding of the way that MVP likes to play. This multiple melee run at you style is just getting stymied right now by the fact that there's just one Sand King with two levels of Caustic Finale.
Yeah.
And this Dazzle sitting behind him, this kind of reminds me of the classic Secret when they were just dominating opponents. back during the Majors time period.
Mm-hmm.
And we're kind of seeing it again, as it just feels like MVP don't really have answers for that. We saw the last heat, the last time that I can remember these two teams matching up was way back in Shanghai when Secret got surprised by them, 2-0'd in the groups. Looked like MVP's kind of chaotic lineups were really good against the split push style of Team Secret.
Mm-hmm.
But this is an entirely new Secret. This is a very selfless one where they pick a single core and they make Eternal Envy play Batrider, and it looks like he's completely okay with it.
Yeah, not too common in this patch to have single core, right?
It's more common on Radiant than it is on Dire.
Mm-hmm.
Just because your jungle can really only support one hero.
Yeah.
We can get into that later.
Alright, well, Secret Arteezy returning back to the game, and hopefully we will have an unpause underway. RCS, not looking too favorable for MVP Phoenix, unless you just want to focus on Ferev, who's at a very happy 38-4. He will obviously need to have a very large impact later on into the game, as his lane has gotten the most preference. He has the most favorable matchup of everybody.
Yep. Batrider also had to rotate for the rune and TP bottom, so he's going to be a little bit further behind.
All right. Dubu, and a little lacking, but when he's matched up with Ferev, maybe this is where the real magic happens. Got a point in every skill, and he's got an Ion Shell on him. Surely, if anything's going to go right for Dubu in this laning phase, it's got to be this moment right here. The 6-minute mark is coming up,
where they steal all the neutral camps.
Okay, that's something. The neutrals away. They did get scattered away by the scan of Team Secret, so they know at least MVP Phoenix did make that incursion into Secret's jungle.
The other benefit there is that Spiritbreaker got to hit a lot of the neutrals without bashing, so he's built up his artificial bash count.
Mm-hmm. Looking for that first hit bash, straight up off the charge.
Right, here we go. Tunnel Envy going to be the target. His Firefly almost over.
Yeah, he has to get over the cliff. Gets away from MP, but can't make it over into the Roshan pit. That means he'll be trapped.
You need one!
70%, and he gets it! Dubu stops Eternal Envy's TP out and will give the kill to himself.
See, it's entirely... It's like the secret, you know?
Uh-huh.
You know that book? It plays perfectly right now. All puns aside. He believed in his ability to get that bash.
Uh-huh. Arteezy popping the unstable concoction, but not the right time for that one. Dubu's going to be able to make the charge in. It's the bash. They followed up with a stomp. They're going to turn onto Puppy instead. Want to try and put some damage on that healer, but Febby's the one actually in trouble. Unstable concoction will be thrown out just in time. Febby run down. Pylon die. He's got the haste rune running in core with Febby. He gets off the stomp. The follow through is there. Dubu, he meets the cell. He gets it, and he gets it. Locks him down. Puppy up next. MP, he's going to rage up. Takes out the other support. Arteezy runs himself away with his ultimate, and no Radiant's way that Team Secret should have taken that fight that deep into MVP's side of the map.
Oh, look at here.
There he it gets is, one the slow motion. Boom!
He gets one chance. What a legend.
What a player, Dubu. One shot, one opportunity. He stops the team just like that. Legend of Eternal Envy is cut short by Dubu.
Dubu's ability to believe and just pull out bashes out of nowhere. This is what wins you a TI.
Unmatched by any other player we've seen so far.
Truly.
At TI. Skill, strategy, we've seen the peaks, but belief really what's separating MVP Phoenix the rest.
I mean, right now, the crazy part is we're just kidding, but it's actually just kind of even the game for them.
Yeah, I mean, that fight at mid actually even out this very, what was, not very, but kind of lopsided laning phase.
Yeah.
You can see just the natural laning phase led to 1,000 lead.
Yeah. It's not bad. It's... I don't even know. I was mainly kidding. But Dubu. Equalizer. Right here he goes again. On his war path. There's no way he completes that one.
Alright, that wasn't a retreat. That was just...
Yeah, calculated.
Yeah. Stalled aggression is what we're going to call that one.
It takes a real tactician to know when you have to stop first.
Yeah. He's right. Just building up some space. Radiant's when the charge comes, it is attack. All the more fierce.
I think he should just die for Puppy at bottom.
Yeah.
Instead,
force
MP,
some TPs, see what happens.
Yeah, they're putting a lot of pressure on this bottom tower. It's already lost half its HP. Up at top, Rev almost has that mech completed for himself. And Arteezy just continues to farm up. And
Dubu, you're going to need to charge out of this one, but not a chance. Two stuns from Secret is all that takes. Take out the Mad Cow 2-3 now, 10 minutes in. Net. We're still looking okay. Rev is going to be pulled out here for the lasso. TP's coming in hot. Oh, but the burrow strike. In short. Oh, too late. Secret will still hold a count of 2-3.
Almost got that blink dagger, though, completed on the Bulba. And I'd imagine once he hits level 9, he's finally going to get that first point of the epicenter, start to get really aggressive with the rest of his team. And this is why Secret's lineup works, is because there's not a whole lot of greed. They can just create space for each other more than anything.
Yep. And we've got, ooh, there it is, Dubu. Claims a kill on the Sand King. Runs him down indeed. And with that kill, it's actually on the precipice of getting level 6. That obviously ramps up the Spirit Breaker's damage and kill potential further. VP Phoenix trying to control runes as best as possible, getting them out of the hands of the Alchemist. And here comes the charge. Ion Shell onto Dubu, running in with the Dark Seer as well. He certainly is, especially with Highlight Dye getting the heal out, but the vacuum wall combination almost hit, and he gets the bash. He had one shot, and he gets it. Kills Highlight Dye, and there is, well, there's no other word to use it. The retreat from MVP Phoenix. They set up with a Song of Siren. Get out of there. They hit the stomp on the puppy, but MVP can't follow through.
Who is this man?
15%.
This legend. Just doesn't stop. At this point, it's getting uncomfortable. Dubu just hasn't doubted. There's no way they should be able to get that kill. Yeah. Like, they should be able to survive there.
Should just be able to tank that one hit from Dubu
and, he just
and
walks
walk,
away.
Walk himself away, but yeah. No.
And then they force the sleep out, and it's perfectly fine, but instead, protagonist of TI6 continues to make his mark. Blink Dagger completed though on Bulba, and that might just be the turnaround that they need.
Look at it.
Going slow.
Boom!
I love that production is down too.
Oh, thank you. Thank you, production.
They're just, it's the Bash best. Watch.
Bash Watch 2016. Uh-oh. Speaking of
There's
stunts.
No way Kyo's getting out of this one.
No. No, he's certainly not. That is the kitchen sink being thrown at him right there. And
really
MP, why did you complete that TP? He had faith in Dubu. That's why the charge comes through. Pops the rage. Starts eating away at Arteezy. Has the infest. Now the long range. Elder Titan ultimate with the vacuum back. They got Artur. They laid him out. And Febby, he's looking for more. He's positioning himself, looking for the stomp. He's got Dubu. He knows it. They've got him. Puppy locked down. Pylite's eye. He comes in. Dubu cancels his ult, but maybe he can't get it off at all. He gets taken out by the nukes of Team Secret as the Wiz lays out the damage with the spirits, and it's gonna follow through onto Febby. Stomp coming out, gets canceled. Febby stops that one as the two-man burrow strike comes out from Bulba, slowing these heroes down. Bulba blinks
forward.
Himself forward, trying to catch Febby still and stay out of the hands of MP, but MP locks onto Pylite Dye instead. He still managed to get the burrow strike. Febby should stick out from this one as Puppy comes in with the shadow wave. Now it's Bulba versus MP. MP holding onto a lot of Weave minus armor, needs to get out of here, but the surge can't get the space necessary. Arteezy can't quite see him until Bulba jumps forward. Reveals for Rev with a burrow strike and the follow-up on stable concoction. MP still thinks he can fight this one, and he's right too. He's got Bulba, and they've got Artur. Dubu comes in. Let me see it. Let me hear it, ladies and gentlemen. No 17%, but it's not needed. He's holding on to that one until Pylite Dye. He gets in stared. Dubu, show it to me. 3 seconds charge. All right. Still waiting on that bash. We got it. Coming in. He knows the fight's going to prolong. He still needs that bash. Eternal Envy jumps forward, blinks forward, gets a little bit of damage out, and
oh,
grabs
an
illusion! What? That wasn't the play you were looking for, Eternal Envy. Now the charge on through. Puppy goes on to him, the big healer, the Shallow Graver, gets bash, holds him in place, but it's not enough. Shallow Grave goes off, Puppy will survive a little bit longer, gets off a big heal, he'll die eventually. Team Secret just are not able to throw enough heroes at MVP Phoenix until maybe now. Bulba comes in, gets a bro Throw strike. Dubu, next one on the mark. Spirits will take him out. MVP Phoenix, they start backing up. They don't want to feed as many heroes as Team Secret did as they ran in one by one. But they don't anticipate for Ev. He's going to get caught. Secret, they thought they were going to go right, but now they move left. Catching out for Ev. The mech might be enough with Febby over the top. Oh my god, for Ev's getting away with the surge. Febby with the beautiful stuff gets the space. He goes for Twilight Eye. For Ev accepts his death and tries to go for Twilight Eye, but it's not enough. Febby will die as well. And what a feed fest from both teams. We're getting juicy here, ladies and gentlemen. We have a dragon on the loose. Infest Lifestealer doesn't pop out just yet. Despite all these heroes being low, he knows one of them is low enough for the Infest damage to pop him, but Pylai dies barely outside of range.
Both teams just opting to not stop. They're just brawling left and right.
The International 2016 and these two teams are playing it.
Goes after the fact that four heroes died, by the way.
Yeah.
So the Darkseer died, came back, then died again. It was just a continuation fight. Not even sure at this point who won that one.
I am not sure either.
Unbelievable.
It feels a little bit like Team Secret just because they got those two kills at the end. Charge in, Eternal Envy. Oh, another three-man burrow strike. Now the lasso laid out. Eternal Envy is still going to go down, but it might have been enough space. Team Secret can still come in, but Pylite die. He can't get off the ult. Both back our teeth. He could have been the target. They're going to be able to lock him down. Bash him through. Bulma's up next. Dubu, give it to me with the Ion Shell. They've got him too. Team Secret, four down. And MVP Phoenix, keep up five. What in the world is going on?
Team Secret forgot that they were messing with Dubu God. It'll always come out on top with this hero.
This is Korean Dota. You don't challenge them to a five-man.
It seems like both teams are like, no, give up first. We refuse to take the low ground here.
You think you'll beat Korea in a game of fighting chicken? There's no way. MVP Phoenix will always follow through. They'll always take that fight. And now Febby, he gets the stomp, leading into Dubu, coming in with Lightning Break, stops him just in time. Eternal Envy plays that one beautifully, but he may pay with his life. Tries to save, managed to get the blink out just ahead of the Ion Shell cancel. And MVP Phoenix start retreating.
We might finally see two teams not battle out in this game.
Oh no, Team Secret, they want this fight. They're going into the tier one tower. Bulba, he's looping around the back. 5 seconds till the blink is up. Dubu gets jumped on. The charge actually goes through. He's going for Bulba. Wants to stop him from getting an initiation, but he gets throw struck upon. But a stomp puts a four-man vacuum. The wall over the top, and maybe MVP Phoenix can run down some heroes. Arteezy, he's going to be the target. MP looks to be able to finish him off, but a Shell Grey comes in at the right time. So MP, a couple slaps to the face, and Dazzle goes down and dead. They've got the open wounds. Arteezy, he pops the unstable concoction. Dubu's going for more. He wanted to be able to get Sand King, but Bulba managed to get the blink away just in time. Four down again from Team Secret.
And Bulba just got the hell out of there. He's like, I am going to be the one that ends this apocalypse. MVP finally stand on top of the carcass that is Team Secret as four go down for maybe the fifth time in this game.
And a Midas for our Elder Titan as this swing in this game is absurd. Team Secret, 1,000 gold lead in the laning phase, and then something just went wrong. They decided, we'll challenge MVP Phoenix, and we could see what happened there. A little bit of up and down, but at one point, MVP Phoenix seemingly broke Team Secret, are now holding on to a 7,000 gold lead and experience.
What am I supposed to analyze about this? They're just running at each other, and neither team's willing to stop. It's like Team Secret gets the edge, and they're just like, let's push this further, and MVP's like, not like this.
9,000 net worth on our Lifestealer now. He is a big bad boy. Armlets, phase boots, desolator. This guy is like 3 or 4 shotting heroes.
Yeah, you see how quickly heroes go down, especially since Forever's prioritizing both of his melee cores to just run in, do the work, making sure that Dubu and this Lifestealer are Ion Shelled at all times. And now MVP get a good amount of map control. They're just going to start pushing it forward as Team Secret. It doesn't look like they're interested in fighting anymore. And with recent results going the way that they have, I mean, Arteezy's even been forced to go for this Tread's armlet build. But not even going to be able to get this Radiance.
That's the dangerous thing, right? This team secret, their lineup should be able to fight right now. Maybe the Alchemist, you want to slow things down a little bit for him, but he did go for the armlet. He went for an early game fighting item, and they've got early game fighting cores. A Batrider and a Sand King. Those heroes are supposed to come online at 15 minutes. They're supposed to dominate team fights, but it hasn't been enough.
What happened to ganking in this game?
No such thing. I don't know what you're talking about. You mean that when Dubu runs at people? Is that what you're referring to?
It's honestly just like, oh, they're sending one hero at us. It's time to show up as five.
Yeah,
there's like so much violence.
In other games, ganking is something that happens and it comes as a surprise to the enemy team. Not in this game. Dubu announces very clearly his intentions to the enemy team, and Team Secret did not give him the respect he deserved.
Yeah, nearly 30 kills in 19 minutes. And there's finally been a lead in action. But
You say that, and just like that, MVP Phoenix, they go for the four-man smoke, rather, with obviously Dubu holding a little present inside of him right now.
Man, this Alchemist has fallen way behind in net worth. At one point, looked like he was easily going to collapse on this game. Ever since those engagements, they're going to connect as QO, going to TP up here. Doesn't have a lot of mana, though. Got to be careful, but Envy blinks up.
Oh. He reveals this smoke, and MVP Phoenix do not get the immediate jump. Thread's still trying to get the vision here. They do get the charge. They're going to pull him back. Eternal Envy just going to get popped like that. MP rips him a new one. 10-20 now as they find the pickoff. MVP Phoenix immediately going to go for the infest and TP down to bottom lane.
Oh,
they
want to pace.
No room for RTZ whatsoever to farm.
Yeah, I'm going to just fall back to the jungle, and I think this is the right idea. You don't expect that kind of play out of any other team but MVP, so you just kind of have to play precautiously, even if it's an Alchemist that has a DD rune. Like, he's holding back his instincts that tell him to farm. He's saying there's danger about ID senses online as MVP going to start slowly marching forward, but RTZ going to lay down the acid cloud, stop any sort of momentum coming their way.
Charge on in.
Hold that thought.
Tier 2s be damned. 21
That's
minutes.
Not...
Don't care. Almost into the Tier 3s, but just a little love tap as they back up. Now Bulba thinks he can punish Dubu, but surprise, MP pops out, and there's the vacuum wall. Team Secret start retreating, realizing that's not a fight they can take, even if it is on their side of the map. They lose their dazzle. Eternal Envy is looking for some sort of pickoff off of the retreat of MVP Phoenix, but not going to find anything. MVP, they've got a Radiance. They've got control of this game. They have Roshan available to them.
There's just something about this team that forces people to forget rational Dota. Mm-hmm. I was just thinking to myself, MVP always has the most exciting games.
Yes.
And it always takes two to tango. It seems like the other team is like, okay, let's brawl.
Colonel Envy seems to have forgotten those famous words that he remarked about causing chaos in a game and making it so the enemy team doesn't understand Dota anymore. Well, that's exactly what MVP Phoenix is doing to Secret right now. The Aegis already in the hands of the Lifestealer, but what they may not anticipate, Dubu making the charge up, not following that one through though. Just hope to be able to get that 22 minute rune.
MVP just gathering up behind this Aegis. They're about to get the Echo Saber up onto MP as well. A lot of farm on this Naga Siren. Not nearly a shutout as she was in that last game, as 22 minutes in, has the Boots of and the Radiance. Would have dreamed of that amount of farm in that last game and this amount of space that his team's been giving him. A lot of these fights have largely just been 4v5 with QO able to create space for himself.
Yeah, and now that MP has so many items, he's got the Desolator. Towers ain't much of a thing. The MVP Phoenix, they don't have to worry so much about constantly fighting. They can start taking some of these objectives.
Yeah. And RTZ does opt to go for the Radiance.
Mm-hmm.
Just at a much later timing than we're used to. And look how scared he is of farming right now. He's going to stack up the camp for himself. Wait it out for a second, see what's up. The double acid cloud on both sides.
If he's not careful, MP Phoenix may spot him out.
They don't know that he's there. And Eternal Envy going to be the choice instead. That is a long time to charge. I'm not sure if he's going to be able to get there in time. If Envy's not greedy, he should be TPing out already.
Oh, but he's not TPing out yet, and this means that the flame break is there. Okay. Very knew what was coming.
Thought with the wave.
Now they see it. Realize, RTZ. He's been farming up these Ancients. Don't manage to catch him in the act, but they will clean up some of the sloppy seconds.
They're going to get some farm out of this, and Eternal Envy is going to meet up with the rest of his team.
As
the
you can
Naga
see,
Siren.
Our new production element here, the Dubu Camp.
Kind of following him around, following ambles around this map. And he's done so much for his team. All jokes aside, 4-4-16. He's been the space creator that MVP needed in game one.
MP has not died yet.
Yeah. I'm starting to kind of get used to that. I remember in our game that we watched, in the one that they lost to DC, they ended up losing, but he's still only at 3 deaths. As once again, Eternal Envy. This time he doesn't have that TP available. The relocate's going to come in as a backup, though.
Okay. Dubu decides, nope, no. The relocate, not going to risk it.
Wait, he was doing that by himself?
Yes. Yes, he
okay,
was.
I thought there was... So he is just... Huh. Like, I figured that there was...
A lifestealer inside of him? No, no.
Nah, he just decided to make that play.
Dubu don't care.
Dubu don't... He honestly does not.
I mean, he forced to relocate. That's good enough, right?
There's a good chance... They probably thought that there was a lifestealer in there. That's why they made that play.
Yeah, yeah.
But imagine if they just bring one hero along on Team Secret. That's a dead Spirit Breaker.
Mm-hmm.
Doesn't even consider that. Blows my mind.
MVP Phoenix. Got this weave on them.
That is a lot of negative armor.
You can't really tank the tier 3 tower with weave on you like that.
Yeah, I think they just reset for a second. Let this guy heal up off of the neutral creeps. There's no rush right now. And the main reason there's no rush is because of how much farm Q is getting.
Oh, taxi driver. MP jumps inside Dubu as he charges across for the bottom lane, but Bulba backs up the defense of his high ground. Eternal Envy still trying to play a bit of space creation game here.
He's going to get out now, though, as he was trying to set up for something with the relocate eventually, maybe even propping up Arteezy up there, who's got the Radiance, but the Naga being up there, I don't think he wants to make that play, especially with the ET following shortly. They've got a gem completed now. He picks one up for QO. They're trying to just play the vision game now and deny Secret as much as they possibly can, so it's going to be Bulba going to be playing that role instead, trying to set up for a relocate gank wherever he can. Doesn't want to quite reveal that he's up here yet, and going to spot QO. Was on the hunt, trying to make any sort of move on top of him, and if he can get the relocate off, but...
That's rough.
Yeah.
Now they found their initiation. They're actually grabbing for Ev, but he does manage with the flame break to stop that charge, but it doesn't matter. The ult still goes off, chases Eternal Envy down.
He's getting
now the vacuum with the wall. Eternal Envy low enough. They will be able to get that kill. Arteezy, one more hit. That's all that's left, but MVP couldn't quite finish him off. Now Bulba, he's next in line.
Does.
Open wounds. MP, 3 or 4 shots. Almost everybody on the side of Team Secret, and he's looking at that tower. He's hungry, but first he's going to get a quick snack and puppy while Team Secret are forced into buybacks.
They don't have the epicenter available, though. They're just hoping that MVP goes back. They're not going to be able to get any sort of return kills without Eternal Envy here, and a lot of damage has been done to that mid tower by this Naga Siren. They could probably just wait for the next Aegis to refresh as well if they really want to.
Yeah, they've got BKB coming in soon for our Spirit Breaker. The Aegis coming down, it would seem like a good moment for MVP to consider respite. Arming up, finishing up their next round of items, such as maybe an Assault Cuirass for MP, and the next round of Aegis before they go high ground.
Yeah, they've got the Mantis style on QO. The thing is, there's no need for them to end because they always have this insurance policy in this Naga Siren. Who can match that Alchemist and farm? And even exceed him. And so Alk doesn't feel comfortable leaving the base at all, so he doesn't really have anywhere to farm. They're trying to open up opportunities using Bulba or Batrider and connecting with the Swiss Bio, or the Swiss Alchemist, but they've largely been unsuccessful, but they might run into MP here as Eternal Envy.
Any pickoff be okay, but they don't even get that much. Eternal Envy opts not to make that initiation. Even with the 4 staff, he felt like there was still too many possibilities for MVP Phoenix to be able to turn that fight.
Especially with all the buybacks popped.
Yeah.
If any fight goes wrong, that could just mean the game. Eternal Envy is going to get charged across the map. Dubu does not have anyone too near him. As Q is going to make the connection, but...
Cancels it, but it's still going to be jumped to get the Burrow Strike. But 2-0, hold the phone. Pops the ultimate. Song of the Siren tries to stop it in time for Arteezy to hit himself with the unstable concoction. Not quite the timing there. Eternal Envy will get charged! He gets hit by that one. He chased back. Dubu hopes to be able to catch E. Not the case. Instead, he pops the ultimate. They'll get Puppy. Looks like he ticked out Shall Grave. Not lasting quite long enough. And they'll get the secondary support as well. The Wisp will return. straight into the hands of Febby with a stomp.
And they know that Eternal Envy,
he doesn't have a TP, and he's not inside the base.
It's all going to come down to Bulbur right now, whether or not he has enough damage to repel them. Even killing one hero or doing damage would be enough.
The rage just used by MP, that's a pretty good opportunity for Bulbur to make a guaranteed initiation and damage onto MP, maybe even killing him. Gotta be careful though of this Radiance. He can't afford to start channeling that epicenter and have that blink dagger canceled.
Not even gonna risk it. Better to wait for his team to go down, as this is a guaranteed set of racks and it didn't even cost MVP any heroes. And more importantly, they didn't have to wait for the Aegis. Gonna reset, continue to go on mid. Secret have to respond to this one. They can't afford to give up this double set of racks. Bulba waiting for the Nagus.
Forward, they are going to be able to grab MP here. Double force step, pulling him all the way behind us. Oh, but they didn't get the stun in time. And now the charge through, hit three with a stomp. Oh, beyond godlike, triple kill, give him the quad. Ultra kill for MP.
He
and
wants the
Secret
rampage.
Say sayonara. They call it GG and rampage. MP ends it in style here in game number two as MVP Phoenix. They may have been dumped on in game one, but game two was anything but that.
What an entertaining game.